This is a glimpse into my life. Life with Eric.
Eric's here.
And I'm Kiley.
And I'm Eric.
Okay, I think we know who you are.
Oh.
So, it's your special day, honey.
Yeah? That's how you want to start the podcast? So it's your special day?
Yes.
What's today, dear?
Today is your birthday.
I want to start the podcast over. That was so disappointing to me.
Why?
Because we're talking about all these good intros and you do that.
Was the one you wanted to do was not a good intro.
Why?
I can't even remember what you wanted me to say.
I wanted you to call me like, I'm not saying you're a bitch, but something else. It was something, some kind of quote like that.
You want me to call you a bitch on your birthday?
Yeah.
I mean, I can.
Give me a, yeah, call me a bitch. Do something with a bitch in it and get me going on my birthday.
Do something with a bitch in it. Well, I don't have that pulled up anymore, so I don't know what it said.
Pull it up. Pull this thing up. We got back from Palm Springs. We're on a 2-week hiatus here, and we all these funny coaster sayings. And I wanted Kiley to start one off, so read one.
I feel like that was an appropriate way.
That was
to
a great
start
one.
Your birthday.
Read one for the folks out there.
Well, I can't remember the one you wanted me
anyone
to read now. Anyone.
That's, it was the one I'm saying a bitch.
I'm looking at a lot of butts right now.
There's one that I like. It said it was a coaster and said, only whores can read this. I thought that was a good one.
You want me to say, yeah. I'm not saying you're a bitch. I'm just saying everyone was in a great mood before you got here.
Right. I like that
me
one.
Me and Nora were having a great day till you came home from swimming. Happy birthday.
Yeah, that's fine.
Wow.
That's fine. Those are
trying to be all nice and sweet, and you just want me to be rude to you on your birthday.
No, because the start out was, the bad thing about the start out, and I can say this because it is my birthday. If I was any other day, you could call me a bitch and
you'd
and
cry
make me
about
go
it.
Cry.
Right.
But you just started you just said, so?
So?
I'm like, so what? So what?
Now, I wanted to keep the audience on the edge of their seats.
Right. Now, when I come to you, there was this place in Palm Springs we went that made these coasters.
Right. And
right. Those of you watching our YouTube, you can see our new coasters out there. I have it propped up there, the Life with Eric coaster.
And where did you get those coasters, honey?
Those are my Christmas present.
Right, that you told me to send back and you didn't want to open it.
Right. But I like them now. But now I like them. No, we went to this place that has these coasters. What's the guy's name?
He's an artist. His name is Michael Weem.
Michael Ween?
Weem.
Weiner.
M.
No,
Weem.
Michael Weem.
Weem.
Michael Weem, yeah. He has. You go to his website, michaelweem.com?
Yes.
Yeah, go
with
to his website.
W-E-E-M, michaelweem.com.
And you get these funny coasters. Read me another one, Cakes.
Oh, boy.
I'm going to keep going through the podcast and read me one. They're so funny.
Yes.
And folks that have a problem with us saying bad words on this podcast, and plug your ears, because you're going to get some today.
Let me get...
When we got Allie, just said cunty on it.
It did.
In Palm Springs, I don't think that's a bad word.
It seems
pretty
not
appropriate. I don't know why, but there's a very big gay community
right
in
and
Palm
to
Springs.
Them,
I think when they say cunty, it means like it's just a funny thing, and they call it
right
like a guy calls another guy when he's being a bitch. I think that's kind of what it is or whatever. But anyway, when you go to Palm Springs, though, there's mostly gay people.
Yes,
we were
is
actually, I mean, being a heterosexual couple here, we were in the minority. But it was a lot of fun.
Yes, we did have a lot of fun. A
lot of bars.
It's also a lot of, a little bit of an older population. And
yeah,
so bars closed down at about 10.
Right.
Learned that, which is fine.
We had a great time.
We never went to bed late.
Nope.
And due to that, we also didn't get shit-faced and we're not hungover.
Oh, that's true. Well, that could have been the fact that it was freezing ass cold, too.
Also didn't pack well.
No, I brought 2 pairs of pants, 3 pairs of shorts,
right,
my tennis shoes, and my flip-flops. I didn't wear my flip-flops or my shorts any of the days.
None of them.
Because it was too cold.
And you only packed 1 sweatshirt that you wore the whole time.
Right.
That was like your
long-sleeve
shirt.
Because I only packed 1 sweatshirt.
Right.
I mean, we should have known that could be cold. I did not think it was going to be that cold.
I did. I looked at the weather and I told you.
Literally 40s and 50s.
It got into the 40s at night.
Yeah, I thought you were looking one of those up for me.
Oh, I got sidetracked.
Yeah, read another one. Just interrupt me and read another one.
Oh, just...
We went to 3 tiki bars, which is
yeah,
pretty cool.
Allie and Brent, who are going with...
Are tiki connoisseurs.
Have become tiki connoisseurs, and so... Yeah, we frequented some tiki bars.
Yeah, that was kind of fun. I dig a tiki bar. I want to get on this tiki tour, or whatever you, what do you call it? But a lot of tiki drinks are real strong.
They're a little gasoline-y.
I thought we had these lined up, ready to go.
No. Okay, well, some of them are, I don't know.
Give me 2 in a row.
I'm a bus driver. I'm having a bad day at work. I'll look, if I'm having a bad day at work, I'll look in the mirror while driving and mutter to myself, "You're all cunts, aren't you?" And then tap the brakes twice so they all nod.
That's. Give me one more.
Whoever said the Bible is the greatest story ever told obviously never heard of my trip to Palm Springs involving three bears, a drag queen, and a Costco rotisserie chicken.
Costco rotisserie chicken?
I don't know what happened to that chicken.
I don't want to know. Is a bear is a big, burly gay guy?
Yeah, it's like a lumberjack gay guy, yeah. Like hairy, larger man.
Like Jason Kelsey.
Correct.
He's a bear.
If he were gay, he would be a
Mary
bear.
Mary Tess, when she was on, she said that. She said, Jason Kelsey's like, because I said, do you think Jason Kelsey's very sexy? And she said, well, he could be a bear.
Right.
And I didn't know what she meant.
Yes,
now I do.
He would be, if he were gay, he'd be a bear.
Right. Would I be a bear?
No.
I'd be a smooth bear?
I don't think you'd qualify as a bear. A smooth bear. Smooth a hairless bear.
Well, I would be a smooth bear with chicken skin.
This doesn't sound attractive.
Happy birthday to you, dear.
Right, good Lord.
I want a little rub down on my prickly
body?
Chicken skin. Maybe you can massage those chicken skin off.
Why do you have chicken skin?
I've had chicken skin since I've been little. And chicken skin, if folks don't know out there, is like little baby zits.
Which is actually
they go over my whole
form
body.
Of eczema.
What?
It's actually a form of eczema, just so you know.
Well, that's why I don't like mayonnaise, because I figured it's like a lot of mayonnaise flowing through the very
but
layer
you don't
of
eat
my skin.
Mayonnaise, so
no,
how would you
that's
have
why
mayonnaise
I don't,
in your
I'm
skin?
Infested with this stuff. But I've had this chicken skin, and every dermatologist, they give you lotions, they give you all this shit, you still have it.
Right.
It doesn't fucking matter.
Well, it also doesn't help that you pick it.
I try not to now. I don't pick
Since
it as
when?
Much now. Since today.
Oh, okay, no. Lies.
Maybe if I drink some of this Juicy Tits vodka.
You'll stop picking?
No. Oh. Well, I'll probably pick more because I tend to do that. When I get more drunk or something,
do
I start.
You?
Yeah, I start.
I don't notice
it must be
when
a
we're
weird
drinking.
Anxiety or something. Like I start picking my neck or hands or something like that or whatever.
I don't notice when we're drinking because I'm not
Maybe
paying attention
to you. Maybe that's why I do it because you're not
paying
nagging
attention
on me.
To you?
Yeah, you're not nagging on me and telling
I'm
me.
I'm ignoring
what
you,
to
talking
do.
To everyone else, and you're feeling all anxious over there in the corner picking yourself.
Right. Well, as we were saying today, it's a very special day because it's my birthday.
Right.
Last night for my birthday, we went to Los Compadres.
That's what you wanted. I had to run some errands, and you said, when you get back, I want to go to Los Compadres. I said, okay.
A couple skinny margaritas, and we're ready to go.
And how many skinny margs did you have?
A couple.
Or three.
Or a few.
Which means that two's the threshold.
Two's the threshold. Three,
three
puts you out.
Three pushes them over the edge.
Yeah,
so
like
I said, you're going for three.
I said, yeah, it's my birthday.
And I said, okay. Nothing's getting accomplished tonight then.
No.
So we came home, and you fell asleep while watching basketball.
Yeah, and I passed out. It's like
you passed out.
It's like somebody hit me in the head with a 2x4. I had a great night's sleep.
I know. And
like,
this funny thing is I never know that you're this drunk. Like, you hide it well.
I wasn't that drunk. I just passed out.
I know. Like, I was waiting for the dog to pass out so I could take a shower.
Right.
And you didn't even know this, that the dog was, like, crying at the bathroom door to get in. I guess she missed me.
No, I have no idea. I
ignore
the dog.
I know.
I ignore the dog because the dog sleeps with her head on Kylie's shoulder and her asshole in my face.
I think it's so much anymore.
I have my
She's
eyes all closed, thinking the dog's all cuddling, and I open
it's
it up. I'm looking right in the brown hole.
It's a pink hole.
It's a dog hole. It's disgusting. I hate dog holes.
Well, I mean, I hope you hate a dog hole. Happy birthday. You get a hole.
Anyway. Yeah, that's what I get for my birthday.
Norse.
Yeah, I'm
hole
so
in your
excited.
Face.
Yeah, that cheers me. I'm usually depressed on my birthday. That really cheers me up.
Nord's really making the year for
right,
you.
Yeah. Now I'm really depressed on my birthday.
So what are we doing for your birthday today other than this podcast?
Tonight we're going to have everybody over to watch the football game on Peacock.
Right.
Because the NFL is hijacking the society.
And we're the only people with Peacock.
Yeah, we're the only with Peacock because we have every station there is.
Right. And so now we've become the host house.
Right. So my mom is coming over and making her chili. She rolled her eyes at me. You want chili again?
I mean, how many years have you been? Ever since I've been with you, which is what, like 12 years?
Yeah.
You've asked for chili on your birthday.
Every year.
So, I mean.
Every year.
It's not like it's a new thing, right?
Tanner was telling me today, is it safe to say you've had at least 54 bowls of chili? I go, 54 bowls of chili?
Oh, my God.
I've had that in a year before.
Ew.
We make my mom make chili for my birthday, and then we also make her make it at Newport.
Right.
Which is kind of my second birthday.
Sometimes she makes it at, like, Super Bowl, too.
Yeah.
I feel like she did last year.
Yeah. So we'll have chili and hot dogs, and we're going to, and Kylie's making some cornbread.
Yep, make some cornbread. I'm going to make a salad, make it a little healthy.
Yeah.
Add some health in there.
Yeah. Today, all the boys at swimming brought and Tanner, and Scott and Tanner bought donuts, so it equaled to be 4 dozen donuts.
It's a lot of donuts.
And most of the swimmers don't even want a donut because they're like health conscious. Yeah, but we all ate one after. So I finished swim practice real hard and everything, ate one donut, my stomach goes.
What kind of donut did you have?
I had a raised chocolate glaze, so it's basically a glazed donut with chocolate on top.
Yes, it is.
It's the best thing I've ever eaten.
Oh, okay.
For today. Yeah. And normally I would have definitely eaten two, but I just ate one. Because that's what
I was. Self-control.
Right.
You're learning that at age 54?
Right. I think I'm getting worse. Like,
I mean, probably.
Yeah, I have no patience. Why do I have no patience now? I should have tons of patience.
I don't know. You're losing your patience. You lost your patience on the dog the other day. I felt
really bad. Actually, that's why I'm sitting back today in this podcast, and I'm so extra calm. Do you notice I'm sitting back and I'm real calm?
I guess so, yeah. I thought it was just a mic
change. I'm just talking. Oh, it might be the mic change. I feel real comfortable behind the mic today.
Did you, like, take a drop of acid or something?
No.
What's happening?
No. What happened is the dog, I'm sitting there rolling on my roller.
Right.
Rolling the aches and pains out of my
back.
And
anyone that has a dog, especially a puppy, knows when you get on the floor, they think it's playtime because you're on their level.
Yeah, so I'm rolling around and the dog starts groping around. I don't really mind. I'm letting the dog jump on me. But I put my head down and the dog flings its head up and hits me right in the eye and headbutts me so effing hard. And I thought it split my head open.
Right.
And I had an episode. And I started, every bit of anger issue that I've ever had came out in that one spot.
Right. You threw roller at the dog, but missed.
Right.
Thankfully.
I've done that with the kids before.
You threw her toy at her, also missed.
A stuffed animal toy?
Then
everything
like,
I threw at the dog,
you were
missed.
Like coming at her, and I put my body in front of her, and I was like, knock it off.
And you dove in front of the dog to save the dog.
I did.
I went crazy. I literally went crazy, and so I said
to
myself.
Do you black out? Do you see red?
I don't even know what I did, because I just went crazy, because I swore my head was split
Understandable.
Open, and it hurt so freaking bad. I was just trying to roll some kinks out of my back. And so I went nuts, and I felt so, whenever I go nuts like that, I felt so bad that I've been real nice today, and I'm like actually happy to have a birthday today and everything.
That's nice.
Yeah, they kind of helped me out of my funk.
Oh, okay. So you needed to just take out some anger on the dog?
I think the anger needed, yeah.
Oh, okay.
I should get a punching bag or something.
Instead of like throwing. Yeah. I know, which then I said, what if you like, obviously you missed hitting the dog. What if you hit me?
Right. I didn't want to hit you, but I don't want you to take any shrapnel, like the roller in the head
almost
or something like
did.
That. I know.
Because she was laying right next to me because she jumped up.
As much as I was freaking out, you were fairly calm.
I really was.
You're like, now calm down. Stop that. What are you doing? And then I just kept going more and more and more.
You did. You were like, I was like, what would you have done if I wasn't here? You're like, throw the dog out the window. And I was like, the sliding door that is. And I was like, you're going to throw a 35-pound dog at the window.
I'll really need my roller after that. Blow my back out picking the dog up. This dog is, you know, is heavy now, so when it headbutts you, it fucking headbutts you hard.
Trust me, I know. She headbutted me in the nose, and I swear to God, I think
you kind of freaked out then.
Broke a little bit of it.
Yeah. Well, she's done the nose to you, done the eye to me. She ran around the corner full blast without looking, hit the side of my knee, so my knee hurt for like 3 days. I'm like, oh, my God. I'm going to end up in the knee surgery
because
this
dog
ran on the side
and psycho.
Blew my MCL or ACL or whatever.
I think those are both things.
Yeah. And so what else? She also, you know, scratches everybody,
right,
and bites everybody. But she's getting better. Yesterday, I had a really good day with her. So
we're working. Well, I'm noticing if I get down on her level, she doesn't jump.
Right. So we're figuring this.
Right.
Dog
she just
thing
gets
out.
So excited. She wants to see you, and her love language is bites.
Right.
Because she does little love bites and then like chomps on you.
Yeah, it's lovely.
So I've been getting down on her level, and they say kisses. Let's give kisses.
I thought her love language was asshole.
To you, yes.
Right.
She thinks you're her plaything, though. She always, whenever you're around, she's like, barks at you and
yeah, she's like a
rolls
buddy.
Over.
She, yeah, she's like, you know, a good friend when you're laying down taking a nap, she farts in your face or something
like
that.
Or she did do that last night,
I know.
Too.
That's disgusting. But anyway, we've been on a hiatus for a couple weeks. We went to Palm Springs for a week.
Right, we did our Palm Springs.
First thing in Palm Springs was our anniversary.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. We made it 4 years, yeah. Honey.
4 year anniversary. Don't say anything else after that. Just say 4 year anniversary.
4 years.
We're used to saying, well, we've been together this long, but just say four
no,
years.
No, I know. We seem to feel like we have to justify our like relationship. I think it's because we're older and we feel like 4 years is not very long.
2.5 years of podcasting.
So I think we feel like we have to justify that we've been together much longer. Like it's
two
legit.
Two bottles of juicy tits vodka. And so look how far we've
come. Is our New Year's resolution to just say how long we've been married and that's it?
I think it would be good.
Okay.
Because why don't...
We don't need to justify it.
The reason it's...
It's our insecurity, right?
Most people that say 4 years married are proud of it. We say 4 years.
But we've been
together. I have a hard time saying 4 years because I'm so old and all my friends are like, 25 years, 30 years, four. Like, what are you?
Just a four.
What are you, 22 years old?
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
At 22 years old, I've been married for the 4 years.
Oh, right.
Pretty much.
Right.
But, you know, I'm just glad I surpassed how many years being married versus how many marriages I've had.
Oh, right.
So three, now I'm four. I'm in the clear.
Is that okay? That's how you're justifying
I've been married most of my life.
Oh, for sure. Way more. Yeah. Yes, you have.
Right. And you know what? If something ever happens, know where I'm moving?
Palm Springs.
Palm Springs.
I mean.
I'm going to move to Palm Springs.
I'm not sure if you'll find a woman.
No, that's the whole point. I don't want one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'll just go karaokeing. I'll go to Tiki Bars.
Right.
You know.
You'll find friends.
I'll have lots of friends. I will have lots of friends. I'll go to my friend lives down there, and Kylie and I went out to dinner with him. And he owns these,
leather and sex shop and like clothing attack, like.
But it's
an adult store.
It's an adult store, but it leans more toward.
Well, he's like
guys.
Half. Yes, that's true. Yes.
Leather. I mean, there's like leather
stuff
outfits.
And he has like athleisure as well.
And he does real well. He's been doing this for years. So we're out to dinner with him. It was really nice seeing him, by the way.
Yeah, the first time I met him, I've heard a lot about him.
Yeah, he's hilarious.
He was a hoot.
Yeah, he's definitely. Steals the show.
Yes.
When I asked him, I say, hey, what's your best seller? And he says, lube.
Lube and leather cleaner.
Oh, yeah. I didn't hear the leather cleaner. That's good.
No, well, because the leather cleaner is the...
I think we get it, dear.
Is the popper.
What?
The poppers.
What's a leather cleaner?
It's actually leather cleaner.
Oh, is that what we're talking about?
Yes.
I just wrote down poppers here.
But it's actually leather cleaner.
And you inhale it?
Yes.
And if you inhale this, it's called a popper.
They call them.
So you sniff
slang
it?
Slang is
so
a popper.
So it's not drugs.
No, it's a leather cleaner.
I wasn't following that.
Yes.
I was telling my cousin about this today.
Yes, it's actually leather
cleaner. So you sniff it.
Yeah.
You sniff it and it makes your asshole more sensitive and your orgasm more sensitive and everything about it. This was good.
Yeah.
This is good information, folks. Get some leather cleaner or poppers.
Yes.
I never.
It is. Okay.
So they sniff the leather cleaner?
I guess you sniff it, yeah. I don't think you swallow it. I think you
This
yeah,
is the weirdest thing
it.
I've ever heard. That's nuts. That's what I want for my birthday.
Poppers? Leather cleaner?
My 55th birthday.
Okay. I'll call John and see what to get.
Leather cleaner? Yeah. What's that?
I'll call John and see what to get
you. Yeah, see what to get. Give me some lube. Give me some leather sniffer, popper stuff.
Right.
My luck, you know what happened?
What?
They find me in a hotel room.
By yourself?
Late. Well, I laid down with a dildo sticking out of my ass.
Oh, no.
And I had a heart attack because I sniffed
you
this leather
too
shit.
Much leather cleaner.
That would be my luck, yeah. I would have a hard time sniffing this leather cleaner.
Well.
That's a sick picture right there.
Yes, it is. There's so many things wrong with that.
Happy 55th birthday.
Yikes.
Found dead in a hotel room or motel room.
Oh, we're downgrading to a motel now.
Yeah, you. Well, I would have to say you were there with me, but when you saw this happening, you just left. I think they're going to need to find him alone. This is not right.
I don't think I want part of this.
I don't want any part of
this. I don't want to be
this.
Implicated in this.
Right. Could at least pull it out before you left.
Oh, that would be nice, huh? Well, I'm pretty sure when you die,
anyway.
you...
I don't think I'd be afraid of sniffing leather cleaner.
Well, let's try it.
Poppers. I don't think it's illegal.
I guess not.
I mean, if it's leather cleaner, it's not legal. Some kind of weird, chemicals.
Right.
Right.
Right. I might have some leather cleaner in a drawer. We could try this later.
Who has leather cleaner?
People with nice purses?
Oh, maybe. I didn't think. I'm thinking like leather bikini pants or something like that.
What?
Yeah, leather bikini pants. Yeah, like a leather, vest.
Do you know why like a sex shop would have leather cleaner though?
Because if you wear leather thongs, it gets leather, shit on them.
Leather like sex.
Or you sweat things. On them.
Right. Yes. Yeah, so you got to clean them.
Or like, they have these things, and I've seen it. It's like a ball you put in your mouth, and then it's a leather ropes
strap,
that go over your heads.
The ball gag.
Right.
Do you want one of those?
That's what you should 55th? Get. That's what you should get me.
I should have you wear that every day.
Yeah, you only take it off for the podcast.
Right.
Though, and I have a lot of stuff to say.
Oh, my God. You and your mom, you get dual gifts.
You're going to get my mom a ball gag for a...
She would like gnaw that thing off just to talk.
Oh yeah, no, that wouldn't last. That wouldn't last a second. My dad.
If you want to torture your mom,
company. My dad will invest a lot of money in that company. I'm telling you. He'd be like, "Where do I get these? And what do I do?" Yeah. I say, "Just
what's
tell
the
her,
warranty on this thing?"
Yeah, just when she's sleeping, tell her you're going to hook her up to the CPAP machine, and stick the ball in her mouth and strap the thing and strap that on her head. It's perfect.
Your mom would die. Die.
That's like some 50 Shades of Grey stuff.
Well, I mean, yes, but
yeah. And my bracelet broke. Emmy, our niece, made me a bracelet.
Oh no!
For my birthday
she could
today.
Probably fix it for you.
Did you see what it's on it?
No,
it's yellow
didn't. With a pizza.
And it's a pizza.
Did you pick the pizza?
Yeah. She said, "Which one do you want?" I said, "I'll take the pizza." But yeah, it just broke.
Oh,
I love how we go in and talk about gay leather cleaner and then, not gay.
Why does it have to be gay leather cleaner?
I have no idea. I have no idea, but.
I think it is more prevalent in the gay community.
In the gay community, yeah.
But
I mean, that's great.
That's great.
And order me some of this stuff.
I mean,
I'm going to order me two bottles of Juicy Tits vodka
and
first.
And some leather cleaner.
And then some leather cleaner. And then
can do.
Yeah. Put that on the list, actually. You know, put it on the Costco list.
Oh, the Costco list. Leather cleaner.
In Palm Springs, for our anniversary dinner, we went to this place called Copley's.
I think it's Copley's.
Copley's, C-O-P-L-E-Y.
I think it's Copley's.
Yes, and it's,
I'm not sure, though.
It's whose house is it?
It's in Cary Grant's old house.
Yeah, Cary Grant's house turned into a restaurant.
Yes.
Which is kind of mid-century
modern. Yes.
And then,
go ahead.
Everything in Palm Springs is mid-century modern.
Right. I think the allure of it, which thankfully I'm real glad we did not do this, is they have this whole, like, when you first walk in, like, the gates, if you will, this whole courtyard in the front of the house with, like, a fountain, and they've turned it into just outdoor seating, and the lights and all the stuff. So that's kind of the allure, is the outdoor seating.
But you know what I'm thinking that was?
What?
Was a porte-cochere, like a turnaround driveway, porte-cochere.
I don't know.
Like, I think you entered around a porte-cochere in the entrance of the house.
We should Google it and see what it looked like before.
Yeah, but it's pretty cool. It's cozy.
Thankfully, we did not sit outside because
it was
cold.
Shit. But people were outside. They
have a lot of heaters, and I think they'll give you blankets if you want a blanket.
But the food was very good. The service was really good.
Yep.
The guy's name was Eric, remember?
Yes, it was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe he's listening. Eric. Hey, Eric.
Everything was delicious.
Very good.
I'm not like a martini drinker. I'm like, give me wine and I'm good. But for dessert, I was like, I'm going to splurge here. I'm going to have an espresso martini.
You pulled a Mel.
I pulled a Mel, and it was the best thing like I've ever had. Even
the
you
only
were
difference
like, this
between
is
you
so
and
good.
Mel with that espresso martini is she had four and you had one.
Right. I could have had four of those. Those were so good.
I'm not a big martini guy, but those were good.
They were delicious.
Yeah, they were
it
great.
Was really espresso-y, which that's what I dig. And
I can't. When we go back, we're going back to Palm Springs with the Waynes eventually.
Yes, and I think we should go there.
Oh, I think we definitely go to dinner there.
I think Mel would very much enjoy it.
And
the espresso martinis.
I always leave stuff on my plate. I'm history.
Oh, you do?
You always say, "Why do you leave the last bite? Why do you?"
Oh,
leave
yeah,
this?
You do. You I just say when we're in restaurants, I don't.
And
have
I always
this.
Leave little sections of everything. I don't.
That's true.
I'm not a plate cleaner.
Clean plate. They say that's good though.
I always leave stuff, but I ate everything.
You
I got
it.
What did I get?
Pork schnitzel.
Pork schnitzel, man. That was
no,
so
you left
good.
A piece of cauliflower. I saw that.
Okay, well, go with me here. Just go with me on here. I mean, I can't remember that much about it.
You didn't eat your
but
cauliflower.
But I would have gave up. I would have gave up my food that was so good for the dessert I had there.
Right.
Oh, my God. It was like a bread pudding
it was,
almost.
No, it was. It was like a salted caramel toffee date bread pudding.
It was
but
it sounds
was like
weird.
A,
it's one of the best things
but
I've
it was
ever
like
eaten.
A dense it was like cake. It wasn't like a traditional bread pudding.
It was pretty dense. It was good.
And I don't really like bread pudding because it's like soggy bread, but it wasn't really like that.
Right.
They took a bite and I was like, oh, actually that's pretty good.
I needed you know what I needed before I took a bite of that dessert.
What?
Leather cleaner. Oh, popper.
It would have made it so much better.
If I would have inhaled that popper before I took the bite of the...
It would have been magical.
Oh, my God. I would have been in ecstasy.
So next time we go back, you need to sniff some leather cleaner before dinner?
Yeah, I'm going to huff some leather cleaner.
Before each course?
Yeah. Right. Yeah, before each course. That's even better. Because
also, we had that mac and cheese that you were like drooling
over.
Oh,
I forgot about that. We got an appetizer, mac and cheese. And they had short ribs.
Short ribs and lobster, I think.
And lobster. Oh, my God. It was so good. Oh, that was good. That was a good anniversary dinner.
That was a great anniversary dinner.
Yeah, and the funny thing about it, we booked it and everything, and it literally was right across the street from our hotel.
Like, we're like, oh, we could
just
walk
there.
Here.
It is. Yeah.
It's literally across the street.
That was the nice thing about Palm Springs. Everything was
relatively close, yeah.
Yeah, and I really do like that mid-century modern look.
It works very well for them down there.
Yeah, it's the whole style, down there, so it's really cool.
That is cool.
One of the, like I said, we had great service at Copley's. And the guy's name was Eric. I told him, listen to the podcast. You might like it. He goes, I thought there was something different about you. You guys were so friendly or something. He said something like that.
Because apparently our personalities, I guess?
I guess. He just said.
Or how we talk? I don't know.
Or he's just flattering us
because he wanted a better tip.
Right. we gave him a good tip anyway. And so, but anyway, there was only one thing that happened. It was a little disturbing. Remember, I kept looking at the table outside.
Oh, it was disturbing?
Yeah, because this guy kept looking at me.
Oh, excuse me?
There was a table of these guys.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
He kept looking at you.
Right.
Why?
Right in the eye.
Why?
I don't know. I don't know. I kept looking over, and I'm like, oh, my God, that guy keeps staring at me every single time.
No, you had to lean your chair back to look out the window of the table of the three gay couples' dinner, and then there was an older gentleman, I think you said. I couldn't see him.
Yeah.
With a turtleneck on.
Right.
That you kept staring at, and then he kept staring back at you.
I was obsessed with him.
You were, yeah.
I don't know why.
I was like, he thinks that you're meeting in the bathroom in 5 minutes.
No, but I, there was something very cool about him.
Because he had a turtleneck on,
like,
maybe?
It's a turlneck. And
I
he
tell
was like,
you, rock a turtleneck,
and he was
babe.
Like the middle of the conversation, and everybody was.
Did he have a salt and pepper?
Yeah, salt and pepper, gray hair guy. Kind of a bear.
But no, he wasn't.
I don't know.
But I like a bear with a turtleneck.
No, I'm not picking up on this guy. I'm saying I was kind of obsessed with him. I don't know why this whole group.
I think he thought you were picking up on him, though. He didn't know
every
you were
time I look, he's
dinner
looking
with a lady.
Me. Every time I look, he's looking at me, though. At least the guy could have a little more couth
than that. You could have a little more couth than that. You're leaning back to look out the window at this guy. I think you're the creeper in this story.
Maybe. I'm sure he looked at me first.
I doubt it, because he couldn't see you until you leaned back.
And then after that, I had to turn my attention to the table across from us. It was a family, and there was an older gentleman.
Well, there's an older couple.
There's an older couple in their late 70s, I'd say.
Yeah, I think that's a fair assumption.
But the one thing I liked about this couple is they were done with dinner.
Right.
And they're very loving.
Well, the guy turned his chair.
The guy was
out.
Like 6'5". He's big dude.
Yeah, he had long legs.
He turned his chair
out. So he
kind of
pulled his chair back and kind of turned to
and
the
crossed
side.
His leg.
And put like one leg up on his knee.
Yeah, toward his wife. So there was a good, space between his wife, but his legs extended all the way to the wife's lap.
Yes.
So the wife proceeds to put her hand up his leg and just rubbing his above his sock.
Like his calf?
Like his calf. Under it. And I go, oh, that's nice. And I mean, she's just being a
loving,
loving, romantic. Yeah. This wife's a great wife. And so then the dessert
comes.
So
quality of a wife is if you rub your husband's leg at the dinner table.
It's pretty nice.
Under the pant.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with that.
No.
I'm sure this happens all the time. The guy kind of acts like, This is just my life. This is what happens.
It just happens everywhere. I get
I flop
a leg
my
rubber.
Big ass long leg over, and she starts rubbing it, and that's what happens.
Okay.
But one thing this lady did, and she was just there talking with the rest of the family or whoever they were with, and she's just rubbing it. He's just casually doing it. So then the dessert comes, and they put the dessert right in front of her. Let's just say it's vanilla ice cream or something. So she takes.
Sure.
She's rubbing the leg with one hand, and she takes a scoop of the ice cream or whatever with the other hand, and she reaches way over. And
over
he leans,
his large legs.
Over his long-ass legs, and he bends over, and she's spoon-feeding him. She's rubbing his leg as she's spoon-feeding
Is that your dream in life?
I mean...
You want me to start spoon-feeding you dessert?
I stopped looking at the guy on the other table right away when I saw this, because I was so enthused by what was happening.
So your brain is torn between the gay guy and the turtleneck.
Right.
And the lady rubbing and feeding her husband.
Right.
And you're staring at everybody who's awkwardly staring back at you because you're creepy.
I felt real good that night. I mean, maybe there's something wrong with me. But but anyway.
What made you feel good that night? I didn't rub your leg under the table.
Oh, someone was.
That was Eric.
Eric the waiter.
Just joking.
Excuse me, sir. I dropped something. But I don't know. I thought it was a little weird that she was feeding him though, and he wasn't like even trying. He this must happen all
right. It wasn't the this wasn't time. The first time.
No, he was like,
yeah, she always feeds me my dessert.
Yeah, and rubs my leg, and I need my dessert.
Right.
Do you know who else always gets their leg rubbed all the time? This guy right here.
Hey everybody, this is Joe LaMonica with LaMonica Custom Builders. You want a custom home from a Southern California premier home builder? Call me, Joe LaMonica with LaMonica Custom Builders. 310-465-3347.
I wonder if Joe would like Palm Springs.
I would say yes.
I would say so.
I think most people would enjoy Palm Springs. It was but enjoyable. But I think
he's been down there a few times. He goes down
there. I feel like there's a little bit of everything. Maybe not like a younger person. I feel like kind of the shows, if you will, like Bravo and stuff, like make like Vanderpump Rules, a bunch of the people live down, have houses and stuff. And I think they kind of make it seem kind of cool. There's not much of a nightlife like they kind of claim.
Well, I think people go there and like rent a house and have a pool and they
right. I think they feel you like kind of go more pack. For like yeah,
pack kind of like have the a house party.
The weather, the
yeah, well golf,
scenery,
obviously.
Golf. Yeah, golf. Yeah. If you golf, it's relaxing.
I think Joe's first wife's wedding. Or the first wedding, his first wedding.
Was in Palm Springs?
I think his bachelor party was in Palm Springs. I think.
I mean, I feel like that could be fun. You're not really going to like bars and strip clubs and stuff, I'm guessing.
I don't know.
Unless there's like a secret part of town we did not find.
Yeah, maybe more Palm Desert or something. I don't know.
We drove there. I mean, maybe. Yeah.
Oh, some. You know what? I just thought of this. Something that was pretty interesting while we were there was the Palm Springs Film Festival.
Right. Had no idea that was happening.
Yeah. Leonardo DiCaprio.
We didn't see anyone, damn it. But although Emma Stone. Swear to God, there was somebody sitting next to us at lunch.
At Cheeky's.
Yes. He was an actor.
Yeah. He seemed like, I don't know. I couldn't recognize him.
Kylie
was obsessed with this guy. I didn't know who it was.
Something. I've seen him in something.
I mean, he could be there for the film festival or whatever. He looked like he was probably from LA.
Yes.
I mean,
and his wife looked like they were from LA.
Yeah, for sure.
I'm pretty sure he was. Don't know what his name was. Don't know who he is.
I kept staring at his wife's coat. Did you see her coat?
I don't remember.
Had faces all over it. Oh. Is there a designer or something with faces all over it?
I would never buy that. But
right, I know. But it was just like, and you know, she had green hair.
She did have green hair.
And so she was like, I don't know, like not goth, but just.
No, they were a little.
Some weird little style. But you could tell they were. And he wasn't like hipster, but a little bit hipster.
A little bit. Yeah. He had like a beanie on with a,
He looked cool.
Yes.
I wish I could pull that off. He looked cool.
He also had a weird little thing where he kept turning his head to the side, I noticed.
Well, I think he might have that if he's somewhat of a celebrity because you might do that if you think people are looking at you.
Oh, I was.
Yeah, and you were, and I was obviously.
But as I'm telling everyone, you guys at the table, I swear to God, he's in something.
And you know what? I did notice that little side movement. I think because maybe he can either kind of hear us or he's seeing us because.
Or he's got a little twitch.
Well, actor's twitch. Better correct that for your next movie, dude.
Right.
But yeah, I believe you were right on that one. He was probably there for the film festival or whatnot.
We're
checking in our hotel. Everybody's like, hey, you here for the film festival? What film festival? But it was the big deal. Allie and Brant tried to get tickets.
To see a movie. The one with Emma Stone.
Yeah.
It was sold out. I know. Maybe she would have been there.
But I think if you get tickets really early. It's very popular, I guess. So
I would think the ones with the famous actors and actresses is popular.
Right. I would say so.
We were convinced that the Tesla they got in the car accident and the person ran was Leonardo DiCaprio. Allegedly.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, we're coming out of the tiki bar or from the
bathroom. Dinner. No, we're leaving dinner.
The gastro
dinner,
pub.
Dinner.
Yeah.
Which you and Allie and Brant were like, we're going to walk because it.
Kinda walk
dinner. I always feel better when I do it. Which
I like
did.
To walk after dinner always if we can.
So, yeah, it was only like a 13-minute walk or something.
Yeah.
Not far. So we're like, we're going to walk. And all of us kind of heard like screeching tires and stuff. And we're like, oh, is someone just being a dick?
Yeah, in the distance.
Yes. So we're like, oh, some douchey person's just driving their car like an idiot. We were wrong. Well, they were driving like an idiot. But they ran into a water main.
Yeah.
Got out of the car and ran.
A water main, but let's call it like a fire hydrant.
Right.
It was like a fire hydrant thing.
Oh, it was just gushing water.
And it was gushing water. And so I go up to see if there's anybody like in the car.
Yeah, we want to make sure nobody's like in the car. Like, because it's a Tesla and like water's just shooting into it, which they're known to catch on fire when there's water involved.
I didn't see anybody in the front, but I just, maybe there's someone in the back. Who knows?
So we wanted to make sure no one was like in there.
And of course, it's freezing cold and I step in the mud
puddle. You should put like your whole foot in the puddle. My whole foot.
I'm like, God damn it. But anyway, people came out, running out and checking out. We got there before the cops.
Yes, we did. They asked us, like, did you see anyone? We're like, we did not.
We did not.
But I'll keep an eye out for someone running, which probably with a bleeding head.
Right. Looking for Leonardo DiCaprio running down the street.
Maybe that's why I was never on the news, because it was someone famous.
That's why Brant said, he's like, I think it was Leonardo DiCaprio. I'm like, yeah, it could be. Maybe it was.
But that was the thrill of our Saturday night.
I know. I thought it was pretty funny when we were sitting in the hot tub and it says the hot tub closes at midnight.
Which
it's
is like
pretty
the
much
latest
posted everywhere.
Any hot tub I've ever been open in.
Yeah. So you go, oh, this is a cool place. People must hot tub late or they keep the pool open late.
Which is awesome.
Right. So we're six of us are sitting
in the
hot tub.
We're like in a small
tub,
kind of boutique-y hotel.
And we're not even, I mean, it's like 9 o'clock.
I mean, it might have been like 10.
Might have been 10, but it's pretty obvious the pool, there's signage everywhere saying the pool closes at midnight.
Right.
And this lady comes out and starts screaming at us. Some people are trying to sleep. We weren't even playing music or anything.
No, we were just literally talking about vets.
It would have taken her. It would have been less effort and everything just to put a pillow over her head and not
say
nothing.
And then how many people did you just wake up by screaming out your door?
Right. Way louder than we are
in
the hot tub.
Because I'm a dick, I'm like, well, guess what? I'm shooting up that volume now just to piss you off even further. So
is
I'm
that,
like loudly.
Is that what you did?
Yes, I did.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Oh, I did.
I didn't know you were actually louder.
Yes, I became louder.
Oh.
It's almost like an unconscious thing. I can't control it, but I did get louder.
Oh, I'm going to be louder on purpose.
Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay, Kiley.
Yeah.
I'm playing this next commercial. You look up one of those coasters. Give me a couple real quick. Just whatever they are. Here's a word from our sponsors.
This segment of Life with Eric is brought to you by
430 National,
Great American Storage,
America,
and Reno Yard
for all your outdoor storage needs.
I can hear the dog munching on this. What is he munching on?
It's a
cow tail? Oh, her.
And yes, it is a cow tail.
Right. Give me one of those. Just anyone.
Even Jesus thinks you're a cunt.
My God. Maybe one more.
Hold on, I got butt cheeks.
What?
There's ones with naked butt cheeks on them.
Oh, the coasters with them? Yeah.
I'm on the naked butt cheeks one. Hold on. Now it's thinking.
This guy, while you're looking for one, let me explain this guy.
We met the owner, creator.
Yeah, creator there. And he was like, yeah, during COVID, I just started making up all these sayings for coasters. And we started putting them on coasters. And they're huge sellers. They're all really, you know, dirty and nasty. But he also made wallpaper. So it'd be fun to have if you had a restaurant or a bar or something, the wallpaper with all these sayings, these dirty sayings. It's pretty funny.
Yes.
Give me another one, babe.
Whenever I'm in trouble, I think, what would Jesus do? Then I pretend to be dead and disappear for 3 days.
That's a good one. I just remember one that we were reading, and it said, only whores can read this.
Right.
I thought that was funny.
You very much enjoyed that.
I wanted to get that one for Allie. But we didn't. What did we get the one for Allie with something drinking one? It said, it's a drinking one. You don't remember? I just thought you were going to rattle it off the top of your head.
I don't think I've seen that one. I haven't seen the one I really liked that was like, some people think that you're like great and amazing or something. And I was like, but it's not me.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, some people think you're. That's a pretty good one. I thought it was pretty funny that we didn't see Jelly Roll at the Palm Springs Film Festival.
Why would we see Jelly Roll at the Palm Springs? You're trying to do a segue here, but why would we see him there? He's not a film star.
I'm just joking because I talked to my mom, and I said something about Jelly Roll. And Jelly Roll is the country singer.
Right.
And so, she goes, oh, yeah. Do you ever see him with his girlfriend or wife?
His wife.
I said, no. She goes, oh, yeah, she looks like a hooker. What does his wife look like, a blonde?
Yeah. Kind of, yeah.
That's pretty nice. Good for him. But anyway, so my mom says, yeah, you know where he wrote all his songs? He has those really good songs. And I do like some of his songs. She said in jail.
What? He did?
Yeah, when he was in jail for years, not for murder or something, but for for stealing and stuff. And she said he wrote his songs in jail. And that's where that's pretty good for Jelly Roll.
Right. Is that why he has all those face tattoos? Because he was in jail?
Yeah, I think so.
How does your mom know all this information about Jelly Roll?
She's obsessed with Jelly Roll. And you know what? Know how he got his name, Jelly Roll?
She knows this.
She does know this.
How?
His mom used to call him Jelly Roll.
As a kid? Stop it.
Yeah.
You're not making this up.
No, I'm 100%. His mom used to call him Jelly Roll.
So what would you be called then? What did your mom used to call you?
Bowl of chili? I don't know.
Gas man? Yeah. Would that be your country saint name?
Yeah, that's my country name. Gas man. Chili roll. That's a gross
chili bean.
Yeah, chili bean. That's my name. If I'm ever a famous country singer, my name will be Chili Bean. And Kylie will be my whore wife.
Okay.
Right.
Are you gonna get a sleeve tattoo then?
Why a sleeve?
It's a little whorish.
Oh, you gotta get a sleeve tattoo.
Yeah, I need a whole sleeve.
Oh.
I'll put a bowl of chili on there.
Another thing I saw on social media I thought was funny that I'm going to bring this up.
I still don't understand why your mom knows all this stuff about Jelly Roll.
I actually don't know why she knows everything about Jelly Roll. She knows everything about Jelly Roll.
She watches a lot of Dr. Phil, we've learned. And where did she learn this info about Jelly Roll?
I don't know. We have to ask her tonight. She just knows everything about Jelly Roll.
I mean, I don't see her Googling him.
Yeah, she must have saw him on a show or something. Like, she probably saw him on like a talk show or something. And he was on there. And he was in jail, and he wrote all these songs. His mom used to call him Jelly Roll,
and
that's how he came up with his name. And you know, his name fits him,
right?
I always remember Jelly Roll.
You do. It's funny because I
just
remember
like
when we first
remember Chili Bean.
When we first heard of Jelly Roll, it was like a 4th of July, maybe this past year. I don't know.
It was this past year for sure.
And we were like, "Who is this Jelly Roll guy?" And then now you're like obsessed with him.
I am obsessed with him. I really like him. I really like him.
You initially made fun of him, and now you love him.
No, I made complete fun of him. I don't take it all back. I take some of it back. But now I'm obsessed with him.
Right.
Now I'm obsessed with him and his whore wife.
And his whore wife.
My mom, she looks like a hooker.
It's hooker wife.
Yeah. My mom watched, well, she might have saw him. My mom watches a lot of Dr. Phil. I call my mom and dad up yesterday morning.
Right.
And they're both having meltdowns.
Right.
And like, it's like an insane asylum over there. They're both having meltdowns. My dad gets on the phone, and he says, "I just want your mom to watch a movie." She can't watch a god dang movie. All she does is watch effing Dr. Phil. And she's like, "Go in the bedroom and watch your own movie."
He wants to watch it with her.
Right, but he doesn't. I know he wants to watch it with her, but
she doesn't want to watch it.
She only watches shows like Dr. Phil or talk shows. That's what she does.
And like, what's that? The doctors? Does she watch? She probably does watch the doctors, huh?
I don't know what you mean by doctors.
There's like a show called like The Doctors.
Yeah.
It's like three doctors that have a talk show.
I guarantee you. And when you get my mom's car, she has Sirius radio.
The doctor
she
station.
She listens to the doctor station.
Yes, she does.
Yeah. And then she actually on her presets, she has doctors and Jelly Roll. Doctor station, Jelly
and
Roll.
And now Jelly Roll.
And Dr. Phil.
I wonder if Jelly Roll was on like a doctor show.
Oh, he could have been. He could have been, yeah. This is my son, Chili Bean.
Chili Bean. Starts introducing you as that.
Right.
Good Lord.
Life of the Air podcast is brought to you by Petrilla Concrete Construction and doTERRA Essential Oil. You can get those from Aisla Mueller. I saw her this morning. And her handle at Insta is at This Essential Life. Last week on the podcast, we got a lot of good accolades, and your sister goes, "I haven't listened, but I really want to listen to that podcast you guys did." I'm like, "Which one?" She's like, "The one that's called Pretty Bird." And I said, "Why?" She goes, "Is that the one where your mom had the bird in her hand and she's putting it in her pocket?"
Yes.
I'm like, "Yeah." She goes, "Oh, I want to listen to that one so much." And a lot of people really like that podcast.
Animal cruelty?
Yeah. It's not animal cruelty. The bird loves her.
I know.
When the bird's bad.
The bird survived. It's fine.
When the bird's bad.
It goes in the pocket.
It goes in the pocket. That's right. The bird nips anybody. It goes right in the pocket.
Oh my God.
Yeah. But mom and dad, they really love each other.
Oh, yes.
And they're good sports. And they always say they don't want to be on the podcast, but then when they're on, they love it.
I think your mom really likes it.
Yeah. And my dad's really funny on it. Like, he comes up with good stuff on it. So we got a lot of good feedback with mom and dad on the podcast.
Yes.
Like that. And also Juicy Tits Vodka. Their biggest seller is at the Tipsy Rooster in
is it really?
Key West, and it's their sixth year of doing business. Tipsy Rooster has been in business for six years. It was a 6 year birthday.
Tipsy Rooster.
I just saw that. And part of Juicy Tits Vodka's profit goes to breast cancer.
Yes, I do enjoy that a lot.
That's good with that. I wonder if it goes to butt cancer. I'm looking at the butt
right
now.
That's colon.
Oh, colon cancer. Well, good one.
Butt cancer.
Yeah.
Wow.
And we did hear Mark and Mel were saying something to me. They really liked when Mary Tess was on our show.
Yes.
They said they enjoyed having a guest that wasn't like family member.
Oh, weird. Imagine
or
that.
Or friend. But, so maybe we'll have her back on.
I think it was a different perspective of
it
like,
was
somebody that's
her on.
Like
in
the, business too, like, if you will, quote unquote, our business.
Let's get another podcast. I got a couple podcasters in mind.
Oh, you
actually.
Do?
Yeah. It's going to take me a little while to line this up, but I have it in mind. Anybody wants a hat or a stemless wine glass, hit us up here. And if you like our show, rate us a 5. We're on Apple Podcasts, Spotify. Subscribe, share us with a friend, and help us grow. You know what else helps us grow? Rubbing the leg after dinner.
That helps something else grow.
Right. My pork schnitzel grow.
Ew.
That's right. Don't worry, I sniffed the leather cleaner.
Oh, boy.
It's all fine.
This sounds like our next date night is going to be real interesting.
Yeah, poppers and lube.
Leg rubbing. Schnitzel.
Yeah, and feed me
and
my...
And hand feeding you dessert.
And feed me my dessert, dear. Well, dear, it's that time. Last call. So who are we cheersing today, babe?
Well, we have to cheers to you.
Why?
Well, one, it's your birthday, so we have to celebrate you.
From now on, I refer to me as Chili Bean.
Right. I would not have Life with Chili Bean if I didn't have you.
I'm changing the sign back here to Life with Chili Bean. And we just timed this perfectly as the dog just fucking got up.
She is. She's in my lap. And I feel like we should also cheers Allie because it was her 40th birthday.
Oh, yeah. We were in Palm Springs for Allie's birthday, too. Which
40th.
Is
the big 40th,
which
sorry,
is January
Swish.
5th. We killed two birds with one stone. We did an anniversary on the 3rd, Allie's birthday on the 5th.
Right.
And now it's my birthday on the 13th. But you won't hear this until the...
Right. So it's be after
17th
the fact,
or
18th, that's
whatever, whatever. Whenever you'll hear this podcast. But anyway, dear, subscribe or follow us on wherever you listen to your podcast, or just go to our website at lifewitheric.com.
And don't forget to follow us on social media for updates and a closer look into my life with Eric. To all of our listeners out there, remember, it's always happy hour here.
Cheers, everybody.
Cheers.
Love you, baby.
Love you, baby. Love you, Chili Bean.
Call me Chili Bean.